Good morning, Medway. It's Friday, October 24th, and I'm Sam.
And I'm John. Welcome to MTV Live from MedwayTV Studios. Sorry there was no intro today. Due to the network outages earlier today, we may be experiencing further technical difficulties, so please bear with us.
Today we're starting things off with a special announcement by Mr. Tominga.
Good morning, Medway. I hope you're having a fantastic Friday and are looking forward to a relaxing weekend. Today I have two thank yous, and I have two requests, and I have two acknowledgements that I would like to make. So I'll start with my thank yous. I would like to thank the staff for a fantastic parent-teacher evening last night. The building was full of energy, and I appreciate your time. I also want to thank the peer supporters for a great time at the grade 9 dance last night. I know that you put a lot of energy and time into that, and your efforts paid off last night. I would like to make two requests today. One request is to remind everyone that Medway is a scent-free environment. The reason for that is there are those in our building who have allergies to scent, and it is appreciated if you would maybe lay off the axe a little bit so that everyone can have a safe environment in which to learn. The second request is that tomorrow we have over 800 teachers coming to our building to do an information, I guess, PD workshop for a Saturday, which is kind of awesome to have 800 teachers coming on a Saturday to do some PD. What that means, though, is that your classrooms are going to be used, and I would appreciate it if in period four everyone would take a look and just do a little tidy up so that we can really show off how awesome Medway is. The two acknowledgements that I would like to make, first is to our field hockey team, who crushed Strathroy yesterday. There will be more details from the anchor desk on that, and also to our cross-country team, who are sending a number of people to OFSAA next weekend. Congratulations to both of those teams, and again, details will come from the anchor desk right now.
Thanks, Mr. Tominga. Congratulations to the field hockey team for winning both games yesterday in Glencoe and securing the TV Raw Central Championship. The semifinal match was against a much improved home team, but Medway's determination led to a solid 4-0 score.
In the final, Medway faced a strong squad from Strathroy. With a slim one-goal lead going into the second half, Medway capitalized on their scoring opportunities and pulled ahead to win 4-0.
Goal scorers were Julie Rowe and Maddie Fisher with two rookies, Quinn Van Steensel, Brooke Wilson, and Emily Francis with one each, and Becky Crowley, who scored one penalty shot.
A special mention goes out to the midfielders and defense for keeping most of the action in the opponent's end. Great job, ladies.
Medway's cross-country team is having a record setting this year. Here's Brooke with a story.
Hi, Medway. I'm Katie.
And I'm Brooke. And we're going to go find out how the cross-country team is doing this season. I'm here with Mr. Hambly. Mr. Hambly, how is the cross-country season going so far?
The coaches are really excited about this season. We had 47 runners come out and join the team at the beginning of the year. We had great results at TV Raw last week. We even had Laura Miller, who's in grade 9, came first overall, something that hasn't happened in Medway history in a very long time. Moving forward, we got WASA, and hopefully we'll qualify some teams and some individuals for OFSAA going forward.
I went around and asked the cross-country runners how they prepare for a race.
I drink lots of water. I stretch before every race.
I load up on my carbs.
I walk the course.
I eat a healthy breakfast.
I went around to go ask some students why they joined the cross-country team.
Well, I had a successful cross-country season last year, so I decided to make a show again.
To get in shape.
To meet new people.
I got cut from football.
Because I wanted to be part of a team.
To talk to Mrs. Radford.
Because I wanted to run with Mackenzie this year on her team.
Because I love Mr. Bannock.
And with that said, it was another historic day for the Medway cross country team at the WASA Championships in Blythe. All runners raced well, putting in efforts that went above and beyond. In total, 9 runners qualified for OFSAA next weekend in Waterloo, the largest number in decades.
Qualifying as individuals were Laura Miller, Brandon Byers, and Garrett Martin. The biggest moment of the day came in the seniors girls race, where the team of Mackenzie Martin, Kylie Pagliani, Molly Miller, Lisa Gibson, Laura Alvarez, and Sarah Gibson beat out St. Mike's of Stratford to win second place as a team.
The coaches also wish to congratulate Melanie Clayton, Melissa Siren, and Matt Talbot, who all finished in the top 10 and should be proud of their efforts. All runners are asked to listen to announcements next week in preparation for the year-end party next Wednesday.
Attention under pressure, actors. Your meeting is canceled today.
Are you part of Medway's Elope or Gifted Students group? If so, make sure to stop by the resource room for 2 minutes with your cell phones to get signed up for the remind messages to hear about opportunities available to you.
Attention senior girls basketball team. We will have a very important meeting today in room 224, Mrs. McKillop's room, at the start of senior lunch. It is very important that you attend.
Mr. Hislop's class had to go to court. Noeline reports.
Hi, Medway. On Tuesday, October 21st, Mr. Hiscock's grade 11 law class went to London Courthouse on a field trip. We went along to see what happened.
What is something interesting you learned today?
We went and saw a second degree murder trial, and we learned how the courtroom was like set up and the people that were in it.
What was the main purpose of you coming to the courthouse today?
It was nice to see how court proceedings work in Canada and see how Canadian law was interpreted.
So what places did you visit in the courthouse today?
So we went to the 14th floor, and we saw the Ontario Courtroom of Justice, where they held all the murder trials and stuff like that. Then we went down to the basement and saw where all the prisoners were held, and yeah, pretty cool experience.
At the courthouse, I'm Nick Paparella, CTV News. Back to you, MTV.
Spirit Order wares are ready to be picked up in the first 10 minutes of junior and senior lunch in room 104. If you ordered spiritware and haven't picked it up yet, please come to room 104 at the beginning of your lunch today.
Last night, the junior girls basketball team lost to the hot shooting Central Golden Ghosts. Despite the score, Medway kept playing tough defense and fought back in the second half. The junior girls basketball team will meet at lunch in Mr. Young's room.
The junior boys volleyball team took on the Central Ghosts last night in the great volleyball action. The player of the game was Lucas Brycraft for exceptional digs and blocks.
Honorable mention goes out to John Morehouse for using his head on defense and David Geisbers for some great serving after coming off the injured list for the first time all season.
Catch more volleyball action tonight at Medway Gym as the Cowboys host Junior Boys Volleyball Tournament.
The girls golf team had a great season sending two competitors to OFSAA. Alexis and Gracie went to find out more.
Hi Medway, I'm Gracie.
And I'm Alexis.
And we will be talking with Maddie and Alex about OFSAA Golf Tournament. It took place on the 15th and 16th at Kingsville Golf Club. Here's Alexis with more details.
Today we're here with Alex and Maddie to talk about the golf at OFSAA. What do you like about golfing?
It's an independent sport and it's just calms me down.
How long have you guys been golfing for?
About 5 years, 2.5.
What did you guys place in OFSAA?
57th.
21st.
What was your best score?
66 at TV Raw.
80 from TV Raw. Cause the players gonna play, 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 play. And the haters gonna hate, 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 baby. I'm just gonna shake, 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 shake. Shake it off, I shake it off. Heartbreakers gonna break, 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 break. And the fakers gonna fake, 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 baby. I'm just gonna shake, 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 shake.
Do you still need volunteer hours? The OSSAA Center in Lucan is looking for students this Friday night from 6 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. to assist with a youth dance at the Lucan Legion. See guidance for details.
Do you like to write? Have you dreamed about becoming a reporter or journalist? Do you still need volunteer hours? The Middlesex Banner is looking for a student reporter to write a weekly article for the paper, which circulates in Middlesex County. See guidance for details.
Joseph cast members, please note that today is a rehearsal and will end no later than 4 p.m. We will work on the same number as posted. We will work on the same numbers as posted on the call board. Make sure the transportation arrangements are coordinated.
Are you interested in joining the Medway swim team? All swimmers welcome. Sign up begins on Monday outside the science office.
Intramurals are starting, and you have your team ready? Here's some information.
Mondays and Wednesdays, and juniors will be on Tuesdays and Thursdays.
Oh, sweet. Where do I sign up?
You can pick up a package during lunch outside of the cap, and if you don't find a team, you can sign up on Mr. Jennings' door, which is room 129.
What if I don't have a team?
There's plenty of drop-in games that are happening every day in the small gym. You can come in and just play. It's a lot of fun.
What's the purpose of Intramurals?
It's to improve mental health in the high school population at Medway.
How do I know when my team's playing?
Well, you can check the bulletin boards outside the gym for your team schedules.
You signed up for Intramurals! Back to you, MTV!
Any student that has not handed in a computer internet use agreement, please do so ASAP, as accounts will be blocked starting Monday. Extra forms are available in the office.
Junior football is playing Saunders today at Medway. Junior football players should be dismissed at 11 a.m. to get ready. Good luck, football players.
This is a reminder to the members of the jazz band to make sure you bring your instruments and music home for the weekend. Please meet at Dundas Street United Church at 6:30 p.m. tomorrow night for our concert Wearing All Black.
The following students need to see Mrs. Radforth in room 115 immediately after these announcements.
Kiana Stevens.
Ben Pato.
Ashton Moore.
Dylan Williams.
Jack Fennell.
And Hannah Litsky.
The Medway girls basketball team is having another great season. Connie and Megan have this story.
What is your favorite sport?
Basketball.
Ball is life.
My favorite sport is basketball.
Ball is life.
Ball is life.
I am Connie.
And I'm Megan.
And we went to see how the junior girls basketball team is doing.
Ball is life.
Who are you playing tonight?
We play Lucas.
Hey, do you think you're going to win?
Yeah.
Basketball is life.
Ball is life.
How is the team doing so far?
We're having a successful season. Our team is composed of some very experienced basketball players and also some players who are brand new to basketball.
Ball is life.
What are your goals for this year?
Well, we just want to keep working on everybody's individual skills and get everybody having lots of fun and a good time.
Ball is life.
How was your game against Lucas on Tuesday?
It's a complete team effort. Beat Lucas 49-40.
I like basketball.
Overall, how do you think the team played?
I think that we played pretty good. We had some strong defense and our passing was really good.
Life is ball. Ball is life. It all makes sense.
Well, there you have it, Medway.
Back to you, MTV.
Thanks, girls. And a happy birthday to Mr. Cushings. Love the tech department.
And happy birthday, Emily Butler. Love Grace, Lauren, Megan, Keaton, and Taylor.
And happy birthday to Rihanna. Love Chris and Maddie. This just in. The places for the Red Hand Contest. Third place was Mr. Humphrey with 12 per capita. Second place, Mrs. Purell with 13 per capita. And first place, Mr. Hurst with 16 per capita.
Well, that's all your announcements for today, Medway. Have a great weekend.
And thanks for tuning in to MTV.